Hey everybody, it's time for High Five!
High Five!
High Five!
High Five!
High Five!
High Five, you guys. You know, I don't know about you guys, but I just feel a little bit muddy today. I feel a little bit, you know? It just seems like there's a lot of things going on that just kind of encapsulate my mind and a little foggy, a little.
Yeah, I understand.
Yeah, but I know this, and this is why I opened my Bible to this. I'm just going to read this out loud. Mm-hmm. Is that, for though we walk and live in the flesh, we are not carrying on our warfare according to the flesh and using mere human weapons. That's 2 Corinthians chapter 10, starting in verse 3. Mm-hmm. For the weapons of our warfare are not physical, weapons of flesh and blood, but they are mighty before God for the overthrow and destruction of strongholds, inasmuch as we refute arguments and theories and reasonings and every proud and lofty thing that sets itself up against the true knowledge of God, and we lead every thought and purpose away captive into the obedience of Christ the Messiah, the Anointed One.
You know what's amazing about that is we always think of warfare, dun, 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 that we're going to go and we have a battle to do. And then we realize, okay, the battle is against Satan. Satan! And we can yell and scream at him.
That's right.
Then we realize, hey, that's not working out so good. So the battle must be, yeah, and then in tongues, yeah, yell and scream in tongues, even though God says it's your prayer language direct to him. But here's the thing. Then we think, okay, none of that's working. So you must be who I'm warring against. You must be who I'm warring against. Body of Christ must be who I'm warring against. And we don't understand what God says where the warfare is. And you're going to like it. I'm going to give you that same scripture, but in a different translation.
Cool.
It's in the Passion Translation. It says, for although we live in the natural realm, we do not wage a military campaign, employing human weapons, using manipulation to achieve our aims. Instead, our spiritual weapons are energized with divine power to effectively dismantle the defenses behind which people hide. We can demolish every deceptive fantasy that opposes God and break through every arrogant attitude that is raised up in defiance to the true knowledge of God. Listen to this. We capture like prisoners of war the thoughts and insist that it bow in obedience to the Anointed One. So here's what it said, just in a nutshell. It says your warfare is in your mind. What are you meditating on? What are you thinking about? And if it's things that are against this word of God, if it's things that are against God himself, then you must wage warfare. Bring it captive to the obedience of Jesus Christ.
So the warfare is not against them or those or him or you. It's right up here.
That's right. It's right up here in terms of what do you really think about who God is?
Yeah.
And that is the crux of what will guide you in times when things are difficult spiritually. Both of those translations tell us that we acknowledge we know God, and that's the basis of what we keep stored in our mind.
Yes.
Whatever situation you're facing today, whatever circumstance you're facing today, you need to judge it by what and who God is in your life.
That's right.
And that will give you the victory. That will mean that no weapon formed against you can prosper when you acknowledge the person of God and who he is and what he says.
So that's how you lead a captive. I'm going to throw this out to you guys. You guys too. What if a thought comes to me that says, I am unworthy. God isn't answering my prayers because I haven't done enough. How do we lead a captive, guys?
We go right here, right into this place right
I
here.
Agree.
We go right into the written word and the spirit. Anything that God has to tell you in your spirit is going to agree with the written word. We find out what God has to say about
us.
And you know what? God is love.
He
doesn't have love. He doesn't exhibit love. He doesn't show love when he wants to. He is love.
That okay,
is
but how do I bring this thought captive? The thought is telling me I don't do enough. I'm not enough. And God's not answering my prayers because I'm not enough. Bring it in. How do I lead it captive?
I would lead it captive by using the word of God and drawing close to God at that time and asking him, what do you think in this situation? What are your thoughts that you could infuse in my heart so that I could have victory? One of the things that I would use is a scripture that says we are more than conquerors. And it isn't just for our personal circumstances, when God says you're more than a conqueror, he means in every aspect of life, flesh and spirit.
That's right.
You are more than a conqueror because of Christ. And if I get those thoughts in my mind and in my heart, then it becomes a lot easier for me to understand what the next step is and what plans to walk forward in.
Amen.
So I would do it by having conversation with the Holy Ghost.
We get to know him.
Yes.
It's the biggest privilege of our earthly walk is to know God. And
yes,
that's exactly what this scripture says, that these thoughts set themselves up against the true knowledge of God.
Right.
Let's know him.
Let's
begin to know him just by going before him.
Don't let your thoughts go everywhere. Bring them in according to the word of God. Bring them in. Focus. And I'm telling you, you are a winner, and your warfare has already been won by the blood of the Lamb.
Amen.
And the word of your testimony. God bless you from High Five.
Yeah,
I feel
God bless
better
you
already.
Yeah.
Yay.
High Five.
I feel
Yay.
Better
High Five.
High Five. High Five. High Five.